What's up guys, Emmanuel here. And today I'm going to show you how to install the new Live Link in Substance Painter and Blender. The process has changed a lot compared to previous versions, all thanks to the feedback I received from all of you. So I hope this will result in a better user experience overall, mainly because it no longer requires editing files in weird formats like JSON or license files. So let's get started. First, download the latest version of the plugin. At the moment of recording this video, the latest version is 10091. Once downloaded, extract the zip and you'll find a folder called Show Live Link. Copy that folder to the Substance Painter Plugins folder, usually located at Documents, Algorithmic, Substance Painter Plugins. We open Substance Painter and enable the plugin window by clicking Window, Views, Show SP Live Link. This will add a dockable window to your Substance Painter UI. Sometimes it will appear minimizing the corner, so just increase the size to see the actual plugin. Now it's time to add the license and install the Blender plugin. Open the plugins menu, Show SP Live Link, Configure. For the license, just add the license key you received from Gumroad and you're ready. Now for Blender, the plugin will automatically predefine the add-ons path, so if you have a standard installation, all you need to do is click the install button and that's all. If you need to use a custom path, you can select it with the browse button. And if you want to open the add-ons path, just click the folder button. That way, you can verify the plugin was installed correctly. Once everything is ready, it is time to verify that the plugin is working. Let's open Blender and enable the plugin by clicking Edit, Preferences, Add-ons, and search for Shotlet. Enable the plugin, and a new tab will appear on the right side of the 3D view, called Shotlet. Start the server. Now on Painter, open a project. In the Texture Set section of the plugins, click Load, and click All to select all the texture sets and geometry. Then click Create. If everything was done correctly, now you'll be able to see the mesh and its materials on Blender.